Hi students, today we'll discuss of science, that is chapter 1, the further. This is immunization. Immunization, the page 5, last one. Immunization, what do you mean by immunization? It means, immunization? It means, you know, pratiraksha, how to protect from any disease, right? So written, people, especially children, are given vaccination to prevent them from getting serious diseases. So vaccination, you know, vaccination, you have seen events in the school, sometimes used to take the vaccinations. Why used to take? To prevent from many disease. So what is vaccine? Vaccines are made of small quantities of dead or very weak germs of a particular disease. So what if the question is what is vaccine? So vaccine is made of small quantities of dead or very weak germs of a particular disease. So whatever the disease, the same disease, we need the small quantity of dead or very weak germs of that disease. We used to that you know, make that what the vaccines made by small quantity of dead or very weak germs or substances produced by these germs, right? So, or the substances produced by these germs, very weak germs of the particular disease, or substances produced by these germs. So, written, they are swallowed or injected in the body. So, these vaccines, the vaccines, they are swallowed or injected into the body. Injected means injections. Swallowed means like the tablets you used to eat. Your students used to eat the deworms tablet at school. Deworms tablets, every year you're eating deworm tablets. That is also like the vaccines. Or sometimes you used to take the injection at schools also. Why? Because to prevent from disease. Deworm tablets, you know, right? When they enter the body produces substances that can fight the germs. So why you used to take those tablets or injections? To what? When you take these things, it will enter to your body and body produce substances. The body what produce substances that fight against the germs, which germs harmful for your body. Just with the germs, you'll suffer from many diseases. That substances used to fight against those germs. That's the reason we used to take the what? Vaccines. Thus, the body becomes capable of fighting any further attack from germs of that disease. So, whenever we take the vaccines in that condition, in that times, our body, is, you know, becomes capable. Capable means what? Suction, you know, capable of fighting any further attack from the germs of that disease. This is called immunity against a particular disease, right? So if you have the good immunity, then you can fight against the disease in a very good way, in a very simple way. So how you should increase your immunity? By taking the vaccines, right? Then written, many diseases such as measles, typhoid, tetanus, polio, and pumps can be controlled through vaccines. So these are very, very, you know, dangerous disease for the society, for the children's. The names are measles, typhoid, tetanus, polio, and mumps can control through these vaccines. Children are usually given vaccines for tuberculosis, polio, diphtheria, pertussis, tetanus and measles before the age of 5. You know, before age of 5, if you remember, you should take the polio. You have seen you know, the lots of advertisement used to come. You have seen in the, you know, anywhere in the, even in the village also, small kids who are less than 5 years, up to 5 years, they used to take the many type of vaccines to protect from the polio. Like polio, the other disease also there, tuberculosis, diphtheria, pertussis, then tetanus, measles, right? This type of disease used to fight. Then non-infectious diseases. What is non-infectious diseases? Some diseases do not spread from one person to another. Such diseases are called non-infectious or non-communicable diseases. So, definition of non-infectious or non-communicable disease, which disease is not spread from one person to another. It is never spread from one person to another. This is called the non-infectious or non-communicable diseases. Then, written deficiency diseases. Deficiency diseases. What do you mean by deficiency diseases? Sometimes diseases are caused due to lack of right kind of food in your diet. Such diseases are called deficiency diseases. So what do you mean deficiency diseases? When you not take right kind of food in your diet. In this chapter, we have already gone through about the balanced diet. We have to take all diet, all food, you know, in a balanced way to get all the proteins in a equal, in a good way, right? If we not take the right kind of food, then disease used to come to our body, to us. This is the deficiency disease, right? Our India, lots of people are poor. Lots of people are poor. Their parents never, unable to give the proper food to their children, so that those children used to suffer a lot. It is not understood. Even you know that in the government schools, the government used to give the midday meal. You know, midday meal, why? To get all the protein, all the, vitamins, everything in a proper way, so that student will become the healthy. They will not suffer from any deficiency disease, right? Then it then lack of carbohydrates, proteins, vitamins and minerals causes deficiency diseases in the body, right? So deficiency is how it's come to your body when the lack of carbohydrates and proteins, vitamins and minerals. If you not take these things in your food, definitely you will suffer from the disease that is the deficiency disease. Then the next page, the next table, we have discussed everything about the what carbohydrates, protein, vitamins, minerals, everything we'll discuss, right? So tell us about the some vitamins and minerals and their deficiency diseases, right? So other thing, other non-communicable diseases. So what about the other non-communicable diseases? You sometimes get a rash or have a bad reaction to some food items, medicines, dust and so on. Such a reactions to a substances is called an allergy. So what do you mean by allergy? You sometimes get a rash or have a bad reaction to some food items, medicines, dust and so on. Such reaction is to substances is called an allergy. So you know that he or she has the allergy. Some more cold is there, then you get the allergy. If more pollution is there, you'll get the energy. Some food never suit you, hai na? Some food never suit you. Those are the allergy for your body. You can get diseases like obesity and heart disease if you eat too much of unhealthy foods. Imagine if you take the too much of unhealthy food, then it will suffer from the obesity and heart disease. Very dangerous. It will be not, harmful for your life also, right? Then some disease like diabetes. You know that now many people are suffering from the diabetes. So written that some disease like diabetes, then arthritis are caused when a part of your body doesn't work properly. Diabetes, you understood na? Diabetes, arthritis, hai na? So when it happens, the part of your body, it doesn't work properly, right? So it's very dangerous. Now you have seen that the old people, sometimes they have the arthritis, they used to always falling down on the bed, they always sleeping on the bed, they're unable to stand, unable to walk, and because their part of the body used to what? Stop walking, their leg, their hands never walked, right? Then air pollutions can cause non-communicable diseases of the breathing system like asthma, right? Sinus problem. So how it happens when the air pollution is there? Air pollutions. Now the city area, the metropolitan city area, big cities, the people suffering for the asthma because they are the air pollutions, you know, right? So when the big cities, the air pollutions, the people are used to suffer, you know, from the breathing, you know, problems. So that is called the asthma. Some non-communicable diseases are caused by bad habits such as smoking or drinking alcohol. So people used to smoking and drinking alcohol. If they drink alcohol, you know, drink alcohol, bad things for the health. Smoking also a bad thing for health, right? For you. So it's my advice to you students, you know, in your family also some people are smoking and drinking. As a you know, children, you must sometimes you must tell to your guardians, you know, they should not smoke or drink alcohol, right? So my request to the parents also, right? Don't smoke and drink alcohol, right? So it will then only students can learn the good things from the parents, from the seniors, right? So it is also what if the person used to smoke or drinking alcohols, people used to suffer from the many disease, right? So my again I'm telling to the students, if you any one person used to get smoking or drinking alcohols, request them please, you know, in our book written that we'll suffer from many disease, many, you know, big disease. So don't drink or smoke, right? Then come to the exercise, rest, and good posture. Exercise, rest, and good posture. So how it is helpful for your body? Exercise, you know, rest, and good posture, good positions, right? Beside eating a balanced diet, you know, beside eating a balanced diet and the remaining clean, you also need to exercise regularly to remain healthy. Definitely, we need the balanced diet and we must need, you know, stay neat and clean. Apart from that, we have to do the regular exercise. What you have to do? Regular exercise to remain healthy. Exercise makes your muscles grow stronger. If we do exercise in the morning times, in the schools, assembly class, why you are doing the exercise? To make your muscles grow and stronger. Right, so now at least at home, inside the home, now we all are staying at home, you're not going outside. At least at home, you can do yoga, right? Some indoor, you know, practice indoor exercise you can do, like yoga, Surya Namaskar, and now these things you can do. Exercise also makes your inner organs, such as the heart and lungs, stronger. You must underline this one. If you do exercise every day, then your heart and lungs become stronger. What? Your heart and lungs become stronger. Lack of exercise makes your muscles weak and flabby, right? So if you not do exercise, your muscles become weak and flabby. Flabby means fat, motapa jayega, right? If you not do exercise, become the overweight, right? Daily 10. Then we'll discuss the extra fat will ignite your body and make you understand these things, right? So written here, right? So written here, extra fat, right? Extra fat, just a minute, written here, extra fat will accumulate in your body and make you overweight and unhealthy. If you have the extra fat, if you not do exercise, then your body will be overweight. And overweight means definitely you'll be unhealthy. You cannot work properly. If you are the overweight, you have the more fat, then you cannot work properly. You cannot walk properly. You'll become very unhealthy. Then your body needs rest to recover and carry out repair. Also, you need to rest properly. You should get at least 8 hours of sleep every night. So it is very important for you, my dear childrens. You must sleep for at least 8 hours at night. How many hours? At least 8 hours at night to become healthy, so that you can in morning you can wake up fresh and ready for the next day. Exercise and rest help the body to be healthy. Definitely, we need proper exercise and rest. We must sleep at least 8 hours to become healthy. Then, here written the posture. What written? The very important thing, posture. What is the posture? In addition to exercise and rest, good posture is important too. So, exercise and rest, definitely it's very important. Then the posture, how you are sitting. Right, if your backbone is bent when you're sitting, it's very bad for your health. The posture is important. Posture is the position of your body. Always sit, stand, and walk straight. Important line, always sit, stand, and walk straight. Right, so you have to stand and walk straight, sit straight. This is good for your bones and muscles. For the bones and muscles, you must sit straight, your backbone must be straight. That literally written slouching, sitting, standing, or walking with the body bent or hunched is bad for the body. So many times when you are doing the sitting in the hall, that in Saturday in the schools, you students are used to sit and your backbone is very bent. So the teachers used to say, you students sit straight, backbone must be straight. That is a good posture. Sit straight, stand straight, walk straight, right? It's very, very important for you. Understood? And this is the table, one very important table is there. Hai na? Vitamin, the right, you can see vitamin A, vitamin B1. Then I can show you. Right, you can see here. So important, this table is very important for you. It's everything, every information is there, right? Vitamin A, then vitamin B1, C, D, then mineral, right? Everything is there. These things we'll discuss. This table will discuss as soon as possible. This is the last one. Thank you.